In today's video, we'll take a look at the life of Anne Boleyn at the French court. As there are already quite a lot of YouTube channels covering Tudor history, please check one of those channels if you are interested in Anne Boleyn's whole life story. Anne Boleyn was the daughter of Sir Thomas Boleyn and his wife, Lady Elizabeth Howard. Thomas Boleyn, Anne's father, was a dutiful diplomat with a good command of foreign languages and soon became a favorite of King Henry VII of England due to his numerous diplomatic missions abroad on behalf of the English king. In 1512, Thomas was one of the three envoys assigned to the Netherlands, an appointment he obtained thanks to his ability to speak French and his family connections. There, he made a name for himself with the regent Margaret of Habsburg, the daughter of Maximilian I of Habsburg, forming a friendship with her, which enabled him to obtain a prestigious commission for his daughter Anne, who was appointed lady-in-waiting in Margaret's service. Anne stayed at the Flemish court from the spring of 1513 until the autumn of 1514, where she benefited from an education then reserved for very few women. In late 1514, it was arranged for Anne to move to the French court in order for her to accompany Mary Tudor, the sister of Henry VIII, on her journey to France for her marriage to Louis XII. In 1585, 50 years after Anne's death, rumors were spread by the Catholic writer Nicholas Sanders that Thomas Boleyn had sent the 15-year-old Anne to France after he found out she had had affairs with his servants and his chaplain. This story is, however, easily refuted due to the fact that records indicate that Anne had been in the service of Margaret of Habsburg. Upon her arrival in France, Anne was appointed lady-in-waiting to Mary Tudor, now Queen of France. Less than 3 months after the wedding between Louis XII and Mary, the 52-year-old king died. He was succeeded by François I, son of Charles, Duc d'Angoulême, and Louise de Savoie. Mary Tudor returned to England and Anne, who remained in France, now became lady-in-waiting to the wife of François I, the 15-year-old Queen Claude, whom she served for 7 years. Although it is well known that Anne Boleyn spent 7 years in the service of the Queen, hardly any contemporary French sources mention her. This is probably due to the fact that the Queen, who was constantly pregnant, imposed strict rules on her ladies-in-waiting and isolated herself from the court whenever she could. As lady-in-waiting, Anne would have been present at the coronation of Queen Claude at the Basilica de Saint-Denis in May 1517. During Anne's stay at the French court, Anne was able to learn the French language. She also developed an interest in art, literature, music, poetry, and religious philosophy, as well as acquiring a knowledge of French culture and etiquette. The quality of the education she received was demonstrated upon her return home when she inspired new thoughts and fashions among the ladies of the English court. It is assumed that Anne served as Queen Claude's translator whenever English visitors attended the French court. Therefore, she would have been present during the celebrations of the Field of the Cloth of Gold in 1520, and there she would have seen her future husband, Henry VIII, for the first time. Anne's experiences and education in France would later shape her reformist view that the papacy had corrupted Christianity. In late 1521, Anne was recalled to England. French court diplomats were unhappy about her departure as, in their opinion, it showed ill will towards the relationship between England and France. Nonetheless, Anne left the French court in January 1522 and returned to England, where she eventually became Queen of England as the second wife of Henry VIII. Anne Boleyn died by beheading on May 19, 1536.